Okay, this activity has to be done using the GeoGebra software. You can find that at www.geogebra.org. It's on page 22 of the quadrilateral portfolio packet. And when you finish this activity, email the completed activity to my email address, brackjacobs@att.net, to receive credit for this activity. Now, if you were to answer the questions 1 through 4 at the bottom of page 22 under the topic drawing conclusions. So what I'll do is I'll walk you through this activity using the GeoGebra software. Again, this can be done at home on your personal computer, in the school library, and there's also other areas that have computers, whether it's a friend's house or the other labs available on campus. So, starting off with the GeoGebra software, here it is. Close this out. There is a newer update of GeoGebra. It's called a GeoGebra 4.2. So when that loads up, let me show you what that looks like. Looks like this. You may be prompted to download the most recent version. It comes up looking like this, and you've got this that other special feature that just showed up. Click on the screen, it goes away. Now, I want to get rid of the axis, so you might remember that this is done by choosing this button here under graphics and removing the axis. Okay, if there's a grid, also remove that. Okay, so I'm following the directions. Again, I have them in front of me on page 22, so first tip is to draw a quadrilateral and its diagonals. So it says draw parallel lines, draw AB. So choosing the third tool here, choosing lines through 2 points, left click, scroll, left click, there are my 2 points. Again, the algebra shows up on the left panel here, so we're going to keep that there for a reason. You'll see soon. It says draw point C, not on line AB. So I'll do that. So I choose second icon here, new point, click off of the line, not on line, but off the line. There it is. It's a point not on line AB. And the next set of directions ask us to construct a line parallel to AB through point C. So I choose the fourth option here. Choose the lower right-hand corner option. Scroll down to parallel line. Forget what that means. Set parallel line. If you hover over it, select a point and a parallel line. So left-click on point C. Left-click on the line AB. Notice it gets thicker, a little darker. There we go. Okay. So it says use the hide feature to hide point B. So I'm going to choose escape. So I go back to my pointer. And they want me to hide point B. So the quickest way to do that is over here on the algebra panel, if you look closely, there's a topic called points. And if you can't see that, if you don't see that, you got to go view algebra. This will show up. So under point B, I want to click here. See how it disappeared? The point is still there, it's just not viewable. So it's called hiding point B. So I hide point B. Step 2. Draw circles. Draw a circle with center A and radius AC. So I go to the 6th option. I'm going to choose circle with center through point. So it says a circle, choosing the center first. That's what it says. Select the center point. Center's A. That was a left click. As I slide over, I choose C, and that becomes the radius. So from A to C, that's the radius. Now I'm gonna escape so I can get my mouse back, and I'm going to left click, and I'm going to make this a little smaller. And I'm also going to hold the shift button down along with the left button on the mouse and slide that over this way so I can see what's going on. So there we go.
Label the point of intersection of the circle with center A and line AB as D. Draw another circle.
So we're supposed to now, after I hid point B, supposed to label this intersection D. And how do I do that? I choose the second icon, choose that option, left click there. I'm going to pick intersection two objects. or intersect two objects. Now what I can do is, I know it intersects here, so if I click there, where I think it intersects, the point D shows up. Escape, I'm going to move that over by left-clicking and dragging.
So great, now it says to draw a circle, another circle with center D and radius AD.
So I'll go back to this option here, center D with radius A, left-click. So, chose center D, but left-click, left-clicking. And then clicked on A to create that radius.
Now, it says, label the point of intersection of the circle with center B and the line passing through point C as E. And looking at the diagram,
we want to label this point over here. Okay, and so I will do that. So again, I choose intersection, two objects, left click. Approximating the intersection to be about right there, left click, and there's point E. Great.
Now, the next step is to draw a quadrilateral, step three. Draw AC, segment CE, segment ED, and segment DA. Okay, so I will do that using the polygon feature.
So, that's this choice here. So if I click here, there's polygon, regular polygon, rigid polygon, and vector polygon. I just want the regular polygon. So, I'm going to left click on A, left click on C, left click on E, left click on D, and left click on A again. And there's my polygon. Alrighty? Now, if I'm not mistaken, I'm going to escape. I think I can undo the color here. So I can say that I don't want any color there. So I think I can say to myself, oh, that's white. I thought there was an option to undo that. Let's see. Well, I don't know, so I'll leave it as is. No big deal. Okay, so now that I have that done, they want us to hide line AB, parallel line passing through point C, and each circle. So I better hide everything other than this shape, this polygon. So how do I do that? Well, I hit escape, so I'm back to the pointer. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go to here in the algebra. This is called conic sections, and the conics are the circles. So if I click, left click, right, so that those circles become white, and then the lines, first line, second line, those are the equations of those lines in standard form. And so there we go. Now I've got my polygon, so just the polygon. So that's super. Now, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to stretch this out a bit so I have some room to see what's going on. Now, if I manipulate this object in the wrong way, it'll turn into a different shape other than this special-looking polygon. So I want to make sure it looks like this. Now, let's start measuring step four, measuring length. So measure the lengths of the sides, segment AC, CE, ED, and DA. So I can do that. So I go to this option here. It says angle. Slide down to where it says distance or length, and click on each side. So, left click. So, notice it changes color. It gets a little darker. Click. Here. Click. Left click. And left click. Escape to go back to the pointer option. I'm going to slide these out. So, what do you notice about the side lengths?
Well, they're all congruent, and that's one of the observations you should make. Then it says to draw some diagonals from A, point A to point E, and from point D to point C. Label the point of intersection F. So this is step five.
So I'm going to draw my diagonals. And I'm going to use the segment tool. Segment between two points. Now, again, how do I do this? I left click there. See that? Left click. Segment between two points. So I wonder if I want to change the style of these segments. Maybe I want to dash them. Why not? Let's dash them. So, there we go. Okay, escape. It says to label the intersection point F. Let's see if it labels it automatically F. So I choose that second icon again. It's the intersection. I'm there. Good. And there it is. It labeled it F for me. Escape. Slide this over just a bit this way. And let's play the game that they ask us. They ask us to measure angle CFE. And I will do that. So let's measure angle CFE. Now, for those who don't remember how to measure angles, they choose two sides, and the last side that you choose, or choose 3 points, the last side that you choose, it becomes the side that is the starting point for your measure going clockwise. So here's what I mean by that. Let me explain it one more time. I'm going to choose this side first and this side second, and that last side that I chose becomes the starting point clockwise for the angle measure. It stops there. Okay, that's how it would measure it. If you change the order and you choose to do it in this order, if you chose, you're trying to measure angle CFE, if I inadvertently choose this side first and then this side last, it's still going to measure clockwise. So this is the last side that you chose. It measures clockwise in this direction. And that's not what I'm looking for. I'm looking for not the large angle, but the smaller angle. So I've got to measure it in the right order. So let's try that. Here we go. So clicking here under the measuring tool, angle, I'm going to choose this first side. Oh, I wonder if it'll work with this. Let's see, it might not. I'm going to try it anyway. Choose here, and choose there. Oh, nope. Didn't like that at all. So I noticed that it was acting a little strange there. It was choosing the whole segment, so I'm going to edit and do that. So let's try this. So I've got to choose 3 points. So here's what I'm going to do. That point, and that point. And there it is. And so I noticed that's a 90-degree angle. So you will have the opportunity to experiment and complete the other 4 questions using GeoGebra at the bottom of the page there, and hopefully just solidifying what you've already learned about rhombuses. So good luck, and we'll talk to you soon on the next video. Bye-bye.